Okay.
Amen.
and his assistant, Bishop Terrence Coleman. Amen. And all the men and women of God, praise the Lord for each and every one of you. And all of the saints, greet yourselves in the name of Jesus. Try to look at somebody and say, we out here to win souls tonight. No, we not here out here to look cute. We out here to get some thugs saved. To the park. Can I get a witness in the house? They over there playing basketball. They over kicking it. Hello, somebody. Amen. They just waiting for us to go get them. Hello, somebody. I know y'all been hitting them up. Is that all right? Amen. But we going to keep hitting them up. Come on, because we claim 50 people to be baptized in Jesus' name. Amen. We claim over 50 before this kick meeting is over. I prophesy that over 50 people are going to come to Jesus and be filled with the Holy Ghost and are going to be in the church. Amen. So I give honor to all the men and women of God. I want to give a shout out to all the saints that are watching from California right now. Amen. By streaming video, send love to my wife, First Lady Rebecca Johnson, and all of my family and saints and friends. I greet you in Jesus' name. I want you to open your Bibles real quick. Amen. Because preaching under the big top, I didn't come to preach to you about the dichotomy of faith. I didn't come to preach to you, amen, about the afterlife when we rise from the dead. But I came to lift up the name of Jesus. And I came to let St. Louis know, amen, that Jesus is the answer. He's the answer to your drug problems. He's the answer to your lust problems. He's the answer to your child molestation problems. He's the answer to the drug dealing. Hello, somebody. How do I know? The Bible said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God, but such was some of us.
All right.
Such was some of us. We over here shouting and dancing, but we shouting and dancing because we used to hang out in the park. We used to get drunk. We used to get high. We used to have sex outside of marriage. But then we met Jesus for real. Because if I don't give a scripture, then, you know, the scholars will be talking about, he didn't even read the scripture. What's wrong with him? Amen. The word is in my heart. Amen. The word is in my heart that I might not sin against him. Oh, can I get a witness? I'm going to give y'all some revelation, but I want to preach to all these folk in the park. I want to preach to these young folks. Hello, somebody. Amen. I brought a weapon with me. I brought me something that's better than a deuce and a 9mm. I brought me something, hello somebody, that's better than an AK-47 and can spit out more bullets quicker. Hello somebody. What did I bring with me? I brought me an axe and 2 38s. Hello somebody. his word. Look what it says. And Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time there was great persecution against the church which was at Jerusalem. And they were all scattered abroad through the regions of Judea and Samaria except the apostles. And devout men carried Stephen to his burial and made great lamentation over him. As for Saul, he made havoc of the church, entering into every house and hauling men and women, committing them to prison. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the words. Crying with a loud voice came out of many that were possessed with them. And many came with palsies that were lame and healed. And there was great joy in that city. Oh, talk to me in the house. A lot of people go to church are religious. How do you know the difference between a religious person and a saved person? A religious person works under the government and structure, amen, of the church system. But somebody that's saved, amen, responds to the move of God. When you're able to respond to the move of God, you know you're saved and you're sensitive to the Spirit. Amen. The Bible said the letter kills, but it's the Spirit that gives life. We got to learn to be led by the Spirit even when we witness in the fall. Different folk have different strokes. You can't witness to everybody the same. That's why the watch this. The Bible says watch and pray. You know why he didn't say pray and watch? Because some of us praying and we can't
a
want to go to hell, to hell. I'm trying to get you to heaven.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, say, well, you're trying to get your unsaved loved ones too. Bible says Saul consented unto his death. Saul was the biggest thug in the Bible. He was banging in the name of the Lord. Some of us bang in the name of the Lord. Amen. We just whoop all over folk with scriptures and don't understand they're human just like us. And the Bible said, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. We can't draw nobody by being stuck up. We got to be sweet. Hello, somebody. We got to be kind. We got to smile when you're sitting there smoking in our face. We got to smile. Hello, somebody. You was called to give your life. We were called to give our life. When God called me up out of Hollywood, I was rolling with Janet Jackson and Todd Bridges and Kim Fields and rolling with all these people. Hello, somebody. And the Lord said, come out from among them and be ye separated, saith the Lord of hosts.
Going
just said that. Because I got saved off of a bus. The church mother of my church, her name is Mother. And instead of her saying, well, honey, I'm a woman, so you need to catch the bus and let me drive the car. But instead, she said, no, honey, you drive because you're a social worker, but I'm going to catch the bus. If she had not made that sacrifice, she would have never met me on the 34 bus. If she had not made that sacrifice, can I talk to somebody here? If she had not made that sacrifice, I might not be saved. Thank you, Mother Janice. Hello, somebody. Because for a whole year, she took the bus out. It took a whole year to bring me into the kingdom. But I'm so glad that that woman sacrificed that car and took the bus. Because if it hadn't been there, I wouldn't be here. You're here because of somebody's sacrifice. I know Bishop Coleman used to drive an old pickup truck. Hello, somebody. But he was about saving souls. So don't get mad if he's rolling now. He paid the price. Oh, can I talk to somebody here? There's a lot of folks paying the price for you to be saved. They denied themselves worldly things to preach the gospel to you and pay the bills. The reason Bishop Bell got you out here, because he cared about souls. Ain't no big churches having tent meetings no more. They got the building fund drives. They want bigger buildings. But he's sacrificing to win souls. So you have to play a part in it. What is the part? There's souls all around us.
Amen.
And that's something, I'm almost done. Amen. We have a tent meeting tonight. And the Bible says Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time there was a greater persecution against the church, which was where? At Jerusalem. And they were all scattered abroad throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Now check this out. Where they went, the Bible said they were under persecution in Jerusalem. You know why? God is tired to the church of the church preaching to the church. God is tired of the choir preaching to the choir. You may not like me, but I'm going to tell you. Y'all cute laying hands on each other in the service and the Holy Ghost getting to moving, and you want to be the evangelists, go to the bathroom and lay hands and spit all over folk and come out, ooh, I cast the demon out. Do you ain't nobody when the Holy Ghost got a demon? You tell me you got power? Acts 1 and 8 says after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, you shall receive power. You want to do a display of power? Go to the hospital. Go lay hands on somebody that got cancer and command that they get up in the name of Jesus. You want to say you got power? Go face the thugs and the gangbangers and the drug addicts. Go walk the streets and decree miracles. And then you'll see the manifestation of power. Janet Jackson said, what have you done for me lately? What have you done for Jesus lately? Even the world know no sense that yesterday's testimony 20 years ago ain't doing nothing right now. Well, when I was 13, I won a lot of souls. How old are you now? 35. How many have been baptized through your ministry? Let's see. Five. How old were they? Oh, that's when I was 13. How many souls have you witnessed to then? Well, child, these demons today, they just circling the devil. They don't even want God.
out. Why? Because I'm scared of the devil. Hello, somebody. But it's time for the saints to take off that spirit of fear and stand up. Hello, somebody. And go after souls. That's what God called you to do. He called you to seek and to save that which is lost.
I'll show you something. How many of y'all did people bug y'all to come to church and wouldn't stop bugging you? Any hands in here? People bugged y'all to come, and they would leave you alone. Remember, you started running from them. as soon as you saw the caller ID, ooh, I ain't here. Tell them I ain't here. Hello, somebody. Come on, you just got the line. Tell them I ain't here. Hello, somebody. Then when you talk to them, say, can you go to Bible study tonight? Oh, I'm going to a party tonight. Oh, my mama want me to. I don't know why people use their mama and their daddy for their excuse. You were sneaking out of windows going fornicating at 15 years old. Now all of a sudden your mama got to give you permission to come to get saved. You and the devil's alive. Hello, somebody. Tell your neighbor, say, you're going to get saved for yourself. Somebody came to my church the other day and told me, I got to check with my mama to get baptized. You just married 3 people and you got to check with your mama to get baptized. She live over in Zimbabwe, and if my mama give me permission, I'ma get baptized. Your mama ain't got a heaven or hell to put you in. The Bible says, save yourself. Turn to your neighbor, say, save yourself. If you big enough to lie, if you big enough to steal, if you big enough to fornicate, if you big enough to cuss, if you big enough to watch dirty movies, if you big enough to watch pornography on the internet, you big enough to get saved. Saul was consenting. That means the devil can't do nothing to you without God's permission. So that's why you got to learn to praise the Lord in the midst of what you're going through. Because God is turning your test into a testimony. Shut up, I'll both of you. I just got a revelation. Watch this. You got everybody on your job. Watch you get fired. Because they're going to watch you come up after you get fired. You got people watching you being persecuted, so that the Bible says, thou preparest a table before me in the presence. So everything you're going through, don't be embarrassed. Hello, somebody. Know that God is taking you through the valley to bring you to the mountain. And when you come through the valley, when you go through the valley, you're going to shake off this people that don't care nothing about you. They can't be that real if you go to the high school dance doing the bump. Doing the butterfly. Back it up. You in the club talking about praise the Lord. Hello, somebody. Then next Sunday you in there talking about dear my God to thee. Hello, somebody. Hey, you got to live holy outside the church. can't get no man because you hounded her. The Bible never said that she that finds a husband finds a good thing. It said he that finds a wife. So what you need to do is be waiting. Learn how to cook. Be waiting. Learn how to clean up your nasty bedroom. Be waiting. Learn how to take a bath, sisters. And fix your hair up. Learn how to be a woman. Not a boss. Come on, somebody. Because God didn't call you to ruin your man. Come on. You wonder why all these dudes turning bisexual? Hello, somebody. Because they dealing with the man's spirit and the woman. Am I on the right platform? Can I get a witness in the house? I didn't say you had to be weak. Come on, somebody. You got to be a helpmeet to that man. Somebody said, leave her alone. I would, because there's too many pretty women to be running after her. But there was a man, woman named Gomer.
That's right.
I said there was a woman named Gomer. And there was a prophet that God told to marry her. God? You want me to marry her? She's sleeping with every Tom, Dick, and Harry. You say marry her? Now, I'm not telling you to go do that. This was a special occasion because God wanted to show Israel that they were whoring after other gods. Oh, can I talk to somebody here? So God don't want you to run after somebody whoring after other gods. But in this particular case, somebody in the world say you can't turn a whore into a housewife. But if you read that book, if you read Hosea, God turned a hooker into a housewife, and she became the best housewife in the world. Can I get a witness in the house? God can do anything but fail. But you let him do it, don't you try to do it. Let no man pull you out of church. Turn to your neighbor and say, he might look good, but he ain't gonna pull me out. Somebody ought to say amen. That's right. And man, don't be so manly that you gotta disrespect your pastor for some woman. Can I say what the Lord said? Brothers, any woman, sisters, any man that don't want to meet your daddy or your pastor, leave him alone. Because if the man, you bring him to the man, that man gonna look and see what's in him. Yeah. Men know men. Yeah. And any woman, brothers, that don't want to meet your mama and talk about your mama like a dog, and you sit up and protect her, you need the Holy Ghost. Don't nobody talk about my mama. I might say something, but you better not say nothing about my mama. What'd you say about my mama? Consenting unto his death. And at that time there was great persecution against the church. Where was the church at? In Jerusalem. Persecution arose against the church at the headquarters place. Why? Do you remember what Jesus told the 11 disciples? It's in Mark chapter 15, chapter 16, verse 15. He told them up there before they got the Holy Ghost. God told you that his will is to seek and to serve. I'm gonna say this last, this thing. We got too many recycled saints. We got too many, we're counting double numbers. We are. Because today, this church is popular, and you go there. Tomorrow, that church got on TV, so now you're running over there. And you get rebaptized and go to the new members class, and there's double numbers going on here. Can I get a witness? They're called recycled saints. But see, that's why when I got saved, wherever God saved me, that's where I stayed. We got too many church hoppers. Hello, somebody. And I'll tell you, if anybody should have backslid, it should have been me. Because my pastor backslid and ran off with a child. Bishop, what do I think? What do I think? First of all, it's adultery because you're married. Second of all, she's a child, so you know what that is. That's child abuse, hello, molestation, whatever you want to call it. So I looked at him like he was crazy. And I'm so glad he taught me the truth. Because when you know the truth and the leader gets crazy, you know he's getting crazy. Saying, you know what the danger that is? I'm gonna preach Jesus to you. I'll preach him tomorrow night. They say you didn't say enough about Jesus. Let me explain something. God showed me that when the saints move around, what happens? Say if you witness to somebody today, you share the gospel with them, you gave them the address to your church. The Bible says some plant, some water. But God get the increase. Yeah. So what if God decides to get the increase 10 years later? Uh-huh. I had a brother that found the track 10 years later, Bishop. And he called the number looking for me at the church. And I was still there. And he ended up coming and getting baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost. And I thought about it. What if I wasn't there? What if I was running from church to church to church to church? What if I was running around like a wild man in the church? I wouldn't have been there to save his soul. And tell your neighbor, this is about souls. I want you to roll your eyes at your neighbor. Roll your eyes. Roll your eyes. Put your head on your hips or something wrong and roll your eyes. And then turn to him and say, you better not leave because I roll my eyes. Turn to him and say, why don't you forgive me and still be saved? Hello, somebody. Tell him, I just roll my eyes at you. People leave the church for dumb stuff. Bishop Baylor said the word, he mispronounced the word. So I can't be under such unintelligence. I'm leaving. Bishop Coleman hooped. Instead of talked, I need some Bible instruction. Well, read your Bible. When they preach in hell, somebody, when they preach, they should be confirming what you read. They're confirming what God has already said to you. Oh, I'm sorry. He's not talking to some of us. Because we're too busy watching Oprah. And I love Lucy. We're too busy fixing dinner. Hello, somebody. We are too busy reading psychology books, and there's nothing wrong with psychology, but we're too busy doing other things than reading the Word of God. Can I tell y'all something? The Bible says pray without ceasing, right? But prayer is communication with God. And the more you communicate with God, you build up yourself on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost, right? But according to the Word of God, the Bible says the Holy Ghost will lead you and guide you into all paths of truth and righteousness. Am I right? But David said, hide your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. If I guarantee you that most of y'all that stayed saved, immediately you went into new members class, immediately you were in Bible study, immediately you were in Sunday school, immediately the word got in you. Hello, somebody. And it's the word of God that will keep you. Don't believe me? Do this later for research. Acts chapter 2, verse 42 says they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine. It didn't say prayer, it said the apostles' doctrine. They were taught first. They got into the teaching first. You got to get the word in you first. Then you got to have fellowship. Why? So you don't watch TV and go off with some of these crazy folk that's preaching anything. Hello, somebody. Because we can go off the deep end. Oh, y'all don't hear me. But stay in fellowship. So bishops can check you out. The saints can see that you're okay. If you get sick, you got somebody to pray for you. Because if you stay home and watch TV, I guarantee you many here, they come to your house. You send him all your money and call on the local elders to come lay hands on you. Oh, can I talk to somebody in the house? I'm going to finish right here. Says persecution came on the church in Jerusalem. Why? Because God's will is for us to get out of Jerusalem and go to Samaria, which are our enemies, the folks we don't like, the folks that we're afraid of, the folks that we don't want to be saved. Them are the people, I don't mean we don't want to be saved. I know we're not as bad as, what's the boy's name? Jonah, we're not as bad as him. Jonah ran because he didn't want them folks to be saved. We ain't like that. Hello, somebody. But some of us got family members, we hope they don't get saved, come to this church. Get saved, go to that church over there, but please don't come here. That means you still got some deliverance. Hello, somebody. You still need to be set free. Can I get a witness in here? If the homeboy from another gang gets saved, I hope he go to the church down the street. No, he might come and serve right next to you. God may take your enemies and make them your footstool. Can I get a witness in here? That's what salvation is all about. For God to save the one that you can't stand. In my closing, pain produces progress. Come on. And what is the progress that God wants? The purpose of a tent meeting is to save souls. Not just for us to come together and have church. How many unsaved folks in the house? Unsaved folks. Lift your hand and say, Bishop, I'm not saved tonight. Amen. If there's any unsaved folk in the house, lift your hand tonight. How many in the church brought somebody that wasn't saved? How many in the church brought somebody that wasn't saved? You brought, everybody brought somebody that's not saved to this tent meeting. I want you to stand up. Whether it be tonight or last night or next week, everybody that brought somebody that's unsaved, I want you to stand in your feet real quick. Now give the Lord a hand for them. Now, all y'all that's standing, I want you to take your finger like this and say, y'all need to be like me. So everybody around you, turn everybody around and say, y'all need to be like me. We need some sinners up in here. We need some sinners. Oh, don't sit down yet. Point at them. Y'all like, I don't want to be embarrassed. I don't want to take that to me later. No, look at them and say, y'all need to bring some souls to this tent meeting. This tent meeting is out here to save souls. Amen. This tent meeting is to win souls. Now give the Lord a hand for them one more time. In my closing, tomorrow night, we got a great message for you. But in my closing, when Paul brought persecution to the church, this is what I want to read to you. And the Bible says, as for Saul, verse 3, he made havoc of the church. He wrecked the church. To make havoc means he wrecked the church. The man was trying to tear the church down. He had no is raising folk up that want to tear the church up. But the Bible says, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Tell him he might try to fight it, but he can't tear us down. Because saints don't die, we multiply. So the more he attacks us, the more we're going to witness to somebody. The more we're going to win some souls. The more we're going to bring backsliders. Somebody ought to scream and say, I'm bringing some backsliders. I'm getting me some sinners. So all night I'm bringing somebody unsaved. I want everybody here, your assignment is to bring somebody that's not saved. At least invite them. Can y'all do that? I said, can y'all do that? How many of y'all, everybody that's going to promise me tonight that you're going to call somebody unsaved and invite them to this 10 meet tomorrow night, I want you to stand to your feet and say, I'm going to invite somebody. Shake three hands and say, I'm going to invite somebody tomorrow night that's not saved. Just say, I'm saved, but I need to get somebody. Amen. Now slap five with three people and say, we're going to get 50 people baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. And tell somebody, God going to use me. Tell them, God going to use me. You watch what I tell you. Tomorrow night is Holy Ghost party night. Amen. I said, tomorrow night is Holy Ghost party night. We're going to have a Holy Ghost party up in this tent. Y'all know somebody. And why are we going to have a Holy Ghost party? Because people are going down in Jesus' name. People are going to get the Holy Ghost. Can I get a witness in the house? Somebody ought to give God a praise in the house. He made heaven for the church, entering into every house. So see, they used to have church in their house. And the Bible says, and hauling men and women, committed them to prison. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere, doing what? Preaching the word of God. And when Philip went out and preached the word, the Bible said there was great joy in that city. Can I get a witness in the house? We're going to have great joy out in this camp, because God's going to change some lives, and he's going to use us to do it. Can I get a witness in the house? Somebody scream and say, I'm bringing a soul. I'm bringing a soul. I'm bringing a soul. Amen. Pain that brings progress. Amen. You might be going through this last year. When I get mad at the devil, I don't cuss him out. I said, when I get mad at the devil, y'all need to try this. You want to make the devil mad when he mess with you? You can get on your knees and bleed the blood of Jesus all you want to. He gonna back up. Praise you want to make the church. Get somebody baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost. And you know what? Then he gonna leave you alone for a minute. Because he don't want to mess with soul winners. He don't want to mess with folks that bring bringing souls. Is that all right? Amen. Let's give the Lord a praise right now. Let's give the Lord a praise. Let's stand to our feet real quick. Hallelujah. Come on, go see the real seat. If there's anybody here tonight and you don't know Jesus, in the pardon of your sin, and you're in this tent meeting tonight, and you have not repented of your sin. Some of y'all said a sinner's prayer, but I haven't found it in the Bible. If there's anybody here tonight that's not saved, I want to give you the opportunity under this tent to give Jesus Christ your life.
Hallelujah.
If you can't get free of drugs and alcohol, I want you to know Jesus is the answer.
Right.
If you need help, I want you to come down here right now. Step out of that aisle and meet me down here and say, Bishop, I want you to pray for me. I want you to pray for me. I need to be saved. I'm talking to sinners right now. Saints, y'all hold on. I want you to turn to somebody next to you and say, neighbor, are you on your way to heaven or are you on your way to hell? If you're on your way to hell, don't go. This is your way out tonight. Tell them this is your way out. Look them in the face and say, this is your way out. If you're not saved tonight, you need to come on down here and you need to give your life to Jesus Christ. never going to see you. If you're here, come now. Don't be caught dead without Jesus. Come on right now. Make your way down to the altar and say, I want to give my life to Jesus. Amen. If you're here, come now. Amen. Is there anybody? Is there one soul that will come down and say, I want to give my life to Jesus? Well, come on right now. Hallelujah. Those little ones, thank you, right there. Is anybody else here? Is there anybody here that thinks you're saved and you're not really saved? Amen. If you just accepted the Lord, that's not enough. You need to repent and you need to be baptized in Jesus' name. And you need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Here comes the ball right now. Here comes the ball right now. We're coming. We're waiting on it. Come on, somebody. We're waiting on it.
Shot. I command miracles in here. Jesus.
Sister, the Lord told me to tell you that if no man love you like Jesus, it's going to be all right. He told me to tell you he loves you and he knows what you've been going through. He said you've been disappointed so many times, but God said I'll never let you down. I have never failed you, said the Lord. In the name of Jesus, when I lay hands on you, pure love, the pure love of God is going to come upon you without a body. Are you ready? The pure love of God. How about that? Lift your hands real quick. How about that? I pray for your household. I pray for your home. How about that? It looks like it's confusion in the midst of your home. And you've been praying. And God said in the name of Jesus, it's about to break to you in your home. Because the Lord said he won't want that stress on you. God is relieving the stress. Take it off over in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, lift your hands. Did you take his hand off? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There you go. Come on, show me the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Touch the body. Touch it in the name of Jesus. There it is. There it is. Come on, sister, where are you working at? Are they trying to give you a promotion? I saw it. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said you are mother of many nations. God said you are mother. A lot of people call you mother that you have not even birthed. And God said, he wants you to begin to pray and bring them. In the name of Jesus. I hear the Holy Ghost say, don't worry, I'm lost in heart. I hear the Holy Ghost say, stop worrying. You can't do nothing about it. I hear the Holy Ghost say, you can't do nothing about it. I don't know what I'm going to see. Come on, shut it. In the name of Jesus. Come on, my son. Lift your hands right now. Oh, my son. Come on, son. How long have you been saved? You're with the Holy Ghost. You're walking with the Lord. I just want to encourage you to don't let anybody turn you away from the right to the left or turn against the word of God. Because the Lord has a ministry in you. God has called you with the spirit of service. And the Lord is going to raise you up. He's going to bless you. He's getting ready to turn things around for you financially. Because I see you had sleepless nights. But the spirit of the Lord say, I give you peace. Heal her body. Heal her body. Lift your hands up. Lift them up high. God said you just touched heaven. That was a point of contact. Be healed in the name of Jesus. I need a woman to touch her stomach. A minister. Minister. Touch her stomach.
Ministry. Do you have any kids around you?
You have three boys, but do you work with kids? You don't work with kids. But how about Shah? I see these kids around you, and I'm praying for somebody. I'm praying for the children that are around you. In the name of Jesus, I break every curse of darkness. He tore that emotion, God. I break it in the name of Jesus. Break it down in Jesus' name. Amen. Woo, come on. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm gonna show God, give her a double door, a double portion of the anointing. Come on, who is next? How about the in the name of Jesus? Get your hands up right now. Ooh. Are you a member of this church? Right. How long have you been here? 7 years. What are you doing for ministry? Done? Bishop, you need to get busy. The Spirit of the Lord said, you got to get closer to him because he has a work for you. In the name of Jesus. And God said, that battle that you've been dealing with, you have the victory now. In the name of Jesus, you've been battling with something inside and you haven't been able to tell anybody. But God said, you have the victory.
Thank you.